Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, we'll be making this lovely pants, a short pants with elastic waistband. And guys, it's very simple to learn. If you like to learn how I make this, stick to the video and let's do this together. Thank you to all our subscribers, and if it's your first time here, you're welcome. Please do like the video and click on the subscribe button and on the notification bell beside the button to get notified anytime we come uploaded. Thank you. If you have any question, please drop it in the comment box below. I'll be there to answer all our questions. Thank you. And we recently hit our first 1k subscriber. Thank you guys, I'm so happy for that. I'm grateful. Thank you. So these are the things I'll be using for this tutorial, and I'll go now and rule out my lines. I have a line rule on the paper that I'm going to use. The first one is my starting point, where I'm going to start from. Then I have 1.5 rule, which is the one I'll use for the band allowance, where I'll put the band, insert the band in. Then I'll go ahead and mark out the main measurement for my pants, and it's 13. So I'll go ahead and mark out 13. The first one I mark out is for the band, so it's not included in the 13. So as you have seen where I place my tape rule, that is where I mark out the 13. So I have my 13 measurements, 13 inches for the measurement of the pants. Then I will rule it out horizontally. Then for the down part, remember I'm going to be folding in my pants, so I will mark out 1.5 for folding in allowance of the pants. 1.5, you can use 1 inch, depends on how many inches you want for your folding allowance. So I also rule it out to horizontally. So I have the first line, which is the starting point, the 1.2, which is for the waist band allowance, and my starting point. So the next thing I'm going to do is to mark out my hip, and my hip measurement from my waist is 8. If you measure it too, you get 8. It differs, some can be 9, but mine is 8. So I also mark it out horizontally. Then I labeled it. This is waist and hip, and the L is the main length. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is to mark out my waist measurements. Yes, I'll be using elastic band for this short, but nevertheless, I still need a waist measurement. So I'll be dividing the circumference of my hip by 4, and my circumference is 36. Dividing it by 4, I have 9 inches. So I'll place the 9 inches. You can see the edge I'm starting from is smooth and is straight. So I'll place the 9 inch on the waist, that place I labeled W, which is the waist. I'll mark out the 9 inches. Then I will add 1 inch allowance for sewing allowance, the same on that waist part. So that will stand for my waist measurement. If you're actually working with elastic, you just need your hip measurements divided by 4 to get the waist. If you use exact waist measurement of the fellow, it might be tight since you'll be using elastic. So I just draw the line down to my hip line. So after that, I'll determine my crotch measurements. And this is the method I use. I just measure what I have on the hip line. If you remember, it's just 10. So I divided the 10 by 4. So I have 2.5. So I just came down the hip line, 2.5 downward, and I marked it out, then rule it horizontally. So for the crotch, I used 2.5. Then I labeled it C. So what the next thing I'm going to do is to mark out, to get that my crotch curve. Then I divided my lap measurement by 2. Then I added 1 inch allowance. You can see. Then if you have your curve ruler, just place your curve ruler there to join that curve to the hip point. But since I'll be using fresh freehand, so I just join the line I have already on the hip. I just draw it down to the crotch part. Then it's easier for me to get that curve from there. So I just connect from that point upward the hip line, as you see. So this is a very simple method to use if you don't have your curve ruler to use. The next thing I'll be marking out is the circumference of where my pants stops. Still on my lap, but I took the measurement and I divided it also by 2. I added 1 inch allowance and I connect from there to the crotch point I marked already upward, just as you see me do. So it's necessary, not just one lap, the crotch parts you take, also take, if it's short, take the circumference of where the short is going to end, because we have different tau. So I measured the tau measurement, the tau circumference, and I divided it by 2. So I cut out what I have already on the paper foot. Don't forget, the allowance I added, which is 1.5, both upward and downward, is for folding. The up part is for my elastic folding, and the down part is to fold my shorts downward. So this is what I have. I'm going to take this now on the fabric. Remember when I was cutting my paper, I cut it unfolded. So I need to cut my fabric now folded. So I need to cut my fabric folded. So I have my fabric already folded like this. Then I place my paper pattern on it. While doing your own, ensure everything is aligning. If possible, you can place something on it to make it stand well, or you just pin it down with your fabric before you cut it out. So this is me just trying to align everything to align before cutting it out. So, and I cut out. Since my fabric was unfolded, so I need to just open up the side, and this is what I just did. After that, I have the 2 pieces, which is for the front part of the pants, cut out already. So the next thing is to cut it, the back part out too. So I just place my paper draft on another fabric that I will be using for the back part. So this is me securing everything, allowing it to stand well on the fabric. On the upper part of my waist at the back, so I'll be going up 1 inch. This helps prevent exposure of my butt, and it also helps my shorts to be well placed at the back area, which is the butt area. That's why when you see some sitting down, it's the trouser, the pants exposes their butts. But with this, it secures the butt parts and prevents it from exposing my body. So on the other side, the crotch area, which is also the flap area, I'll mark out 2 inches outward. I will extend the 2 inches above to the waist, to the 1 inch I mark out on the waistline, just as you see me do. Then the 2 inches too, I will also extend it downward. Then for the cushed parts at the back, so I'll come out 3 inches. This end allows the back pants to also accommodate the butt. So I'll come out 3 inches. Then I'll connect the 3 inches to the 2 inches that I marked up. I'll cuff it, not straight. I'll ensure it's cuff. Just watch what I do, and you can use that method and do your own. This is very simple if you are using your cuff ruler, but this is to the advantage of us using our free hand. So you just mark out the 2 inches downward, mark it 2 inches downward. Then the cuff part that you already mark out 3 inches, so just connect it with cuff. There's nothing too serious in this back part. Just ensure everything is cuff and there's enough allowance to accommodate the butt part. So for the thigh area, so I will also mark out 2 inches. Marking out the 2 inches on the thigh area for the back part. And I'll be connecting it upward to the point I already have marked out. So I'm going to be using my ruler to do that. And I'll go ahead and cut it out. So before I cut out the back part, I forgot to slant the 1 inch that I came up on the waistline. So I'll be slanting it towards the side of the knicker, not toward the cush or the flap area. It's towards the side of the knicker. Okay, so this is what I have for the front and the back parts, and I want to take it now to my sewing machine to stitch it together. So exactly what I'm going to do. And this is just for the front part of the shorts. So I make the front part of the fabric to face the front part, and exactly what I'm going to do to the back side too. So this is me stitching it together on the machine, and this is what I have after I'm done stitching the front and the back part. So the next thing I'm going to do is placing the front part on the back part, and if you notice well, you see that the back part is a bit bigger, lengthier than the front part. Yeah, it's okay like that. So I'm going to be stitching it side by side. So exactly the way I place it on each other, I will take it to the sewing machine and stitch this part together, and also stitch the other edge together. I stitch it down with less than 0.5 inches. After I'm done stitching this part, so I have the down parts opened. As you see, I'll just take it to the sewing machine and stitch it together. Just the way you see me open it. As I'm done, this is the next thing I'm going to be doing. The 1.5 inches allowance that I left upward and for the down parts, I'm going to close it down now. And this part now is exactly where I'm going to fix in my elastic band. So this is... So I'll just fold it in a bit and stitch around the waist area. So when I'm done with that, I'll also do the same for this down part. I also stitch it round on both sides. Then another thing you can do is just to secure all these points, this part that you're going to stitch together, just secure it with your safety pin. And if you secure it down already, it will be very easier for you to just sew without getting ruffle or without any difficulties. And this is exactly what I was explaining. I'm going to fold in small parts of it and also stitch it with my sewing machine. You can see how I'm folding it in to stitch it. And please, when you are doing this, ensure the one you are folding in is not much so that you have enough allowance to enter that 1-inch elastic band that you are going to pass in later on. And this is me just stitching everything around, both the down parts and the upper parts. As you can see, we partially have our shorts pants partially ready. And the next thing I'm going to be doing is to pass in my elastic band. I will link a video below where I show how you can sew and also pass in your elastic band as you are sewing, stitching the clothes, also passing the elastic band. But this one, I already stitched the part I'm going to pass in the elastic band, so I'll pass this elastic band separately. And this is done after I'm already done stitching around the parts I'm going to fix this. So there's something I didn't close up every part, so I left these parts. As you are seeing, I left this small part. It will enable me to pass in my elastic band easily. So this is what I do. I'll just pass in my elastic band through this hole that is left unstitched. So at this point, there's nothing serious to do. If you have any method you use to pass in your elastic band through the hole, just go ahead and use the method. But I'll be using a safety pin to pass this in. And this is what I have after I'm done. And this is the last point of it. So I'll just take it to my sewing machine and stitch it together. Then close up that open place that I passed the elastic through. And that is all, guys. Thank you for watching this video.